They'll look to throw for it on third and one. Throwing into traffic there, and that's complete. 3 yards there, good enough to keep the drive moving.
Would it be safe to say that as precise as routes are supposed to be run in the NFL, maybe they're not quite as precise in college ball?
That's accurate, yeah.
And I think we saw a college route in the NFL there. Just find the soft spot, find the dead zone, and find the first down. And that's what he just did.
And oh, look at that, a diving catch. 22 yards on the pickup there. And it'll give the Falcons a first down.
Hey, did you have one of those backyards that you had one of those, like, mats or pits like you have for high jumpers? And, you know, you had your friends throw the ball and you tried to make the spectacular catches.
We didn't need a mat.
You just did it with the ground?
Absolutely.
That explains your toughness. That explains your toughness right there. Because I think that guy was raised just like you. What a catch.
Clock showing 90 seconds to go in the third. Second and 10, he'll look to throw again. And his pass, incomplete. Charles Clay is tight end, the intended target. And that'll make it third down.
If you're a defender, one of the fun things about playing zone defenses, especially in today's football, is that it's not as static as it was in the good old days, meaning you just dropped to a point and reacted to the football. Now you end up with a lot of man-to-man principles once you get into your zone defense. In other words, get to your assignment and then locate a guy coming into your area, and then you end up covering him almost man for man. That allows him to make more plays on the football like the one we just saw there.
Call it a pickup of 7, and that'll bring up fourth down.
Partner, I think that completion takes the definition of dink and dunk to a different level, doesn't it?
It does, and the defense was right there, kind of played into their hands. And the 10-year vet knocks it through the goalpost. And a second field goal here cuts their deficit to 14-6 now. So the drive takes them inside the 10, but it ends with just 3.
And a nice job defensively to rise up and make sure they didn't get
the kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And he'll get it up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. The Titan offense now as they make their way back onto the field. And last time the formula was pretty simple. One play drive, long pass. That maybe they just want to do that again, right?
And that's exactly how you want to draw things up. Whether it's on your grease board, right, in your playbook, one play drive's exactly what you want on offense. What they have to be careful of is not having a letdown. It was barely easy last time. They can't expect that going forward.
Yeah, we'll see if it's that easy here.
Personal foul, face mask, defense.
Got the hand caught up in the grill of the face mask, 15-yard penalty.
So tough for a defender. You're trying so hard to make a play, and the way that these offensive guys can move around, sometimes your hand gets into the wrong place.
Hurry up, here we go. Great.
They'll look to throw now on first down. And incomplete, he dropped it. Maybe a rookie mistake there. Second down.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
He'll try again with the arm here on second down. Throwing middle, and it's complete. And he'll be taken down at the 44-yard line. It'll be a pickup of 10 yards. And they'll be faced with a third and inches. They're going to hurry back to the line now. Now a handoff here to his running back. Back now in Nashville. It's the Titans. They've got the football. They'll be looking to extend their lead here as we begin the fourth quarter. So the run moves the chains, and here we go on first down. Again, we'll see the pistol here. They'll look to throw here. Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete. 7 yards there on the first down screen play. So second down, 3 yards to go now. On play action, they'll throw. On the move to his left. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. Charles, I know it's hard when live bullets are flying, but you cannot keep your hand up around the face mask area.
It is absolutely inexcusable nowadays. We talk about target areas all the time. You have to aim lower so that your hand doesn't get involved in the face mask.
Here we go now. Green 39. Green 39.
Now Barkley. And they will not get the connection there. It's incomplete.
And that incompletion was caused by the defense. I think they were trying to get one into the middle of the field, trying to find a receiver there. But they were in zone defense. And what are the advantages of being in zone? Eyes and reaction. Eyes meaning all eyes are on the quarterback and able to react when he throws the football and rally to that spot. And that's exactly what happened there. Able to get there and knock it away.
Looking left side and completing it to Thomas. 17 yards on the pickup there, and the drive will continue. And the numbers comparison, and something tells me he likes the numbers a little better for this week. What do you think?
No doubt about it. And, you know, we often look for the deep meaning about, okay, why did this happen last week and this one, this. Sometimes you just play better, and we're seeing that from him. Looks happy, loose, running around, and making plays.
A gain of 6 there on first.
One of the feature points of the end route is being able to make a nice throw to the middle part of the field. And for a quarterback, that's one of the better throws and better looks that he'll get. But he has to be careful not to wait too long and let his receiver wander into some tough territory. If he's late with the ball, he can get his receiver hit and hit hard.
Now it's Dixon. And he'll be a couple yards shy of the red zone here at the 22-yard line. They get 9 out of that one, and as a result, the drive continues.
So many teams want to throw the ball in this situation nowadays, but I love watching a team that has enough confidence to go ahead and run the football in that situation. That's almost a tendency breaker.
Thomas, the lone receiver, left. Now flags come flying in. One of the Falcons moved early.
False start, offense.
Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. He's going to take a shot for the end zone. And this would have been intercepted if he could have gotten the feet in. He didn't, so it's incomplete. Boy, that one really could have turned this thing upside down.
When teams take shots at the end zone, you've got to defend it the same way you would defend the first down sticks. You defend the goal line exactly the same way. They can't cross that. You play through the receivers. On that play, that's exactly what they did and batted it away.
Sideline throw, it's complete. And a nice job there of keeping the toes in bed. So they're challenging the spot. If you're a coach, you hesitate to throw the flag anytime it's a spot discernment.
You certainly do, because you feel like that's not one you're likely to win, and you may need that challenge flag for later in the game.
I'm sure as a coach, when you throw the flag, you hold your breath, and then you get the verification you were right, a sigh of relief.
Not only a sigh of relief, a little vindication as well, because every time you pull that red flag and throw it, you could be costing your team a timeout.
Give him 9 on the play, and that's going to make it 4th down.
A short gain that doesn't get them the first down brings up a 4th down situation.
Really nice job defensively. They knew where the sticks were. They got the stop before it. One score down. Here we go. They're going to go for it here on 4th down.
Let's go. Green 39.
Got a try it here. He's back to throw. And no, it's incomplete. Boy, it looked like he had it and dropped it. And as a result, it'll be Titan football on the turnover on downs. So the failure to convert, no doubt, really hurts. But this one's not over. A good chunk of time on the clock and the timeouts.
Yeah, not only do they have the timeouts, as you just noted, they're going to get an extra one with the two-minute warning. And that's going to help them big way. So in a sense, they have four timeouts in their pocket. The big thing, stopping them on defense now. They can't let them get a first down and make them use their timeouts and get a fresh set of downs. They've got to stop them right here. And if so, they've still got an opportunity.
The tight end in motion right. On second down, they'll try and run the counter. And not a whole lot to speak of there as they'll bring him down shy of the 20. Call it a gain of a yard, and it's going to bring up third and five. The fourth quarter here, they've got the lead. They want to keep it on the ground. That's what they're doing.
Smart football. Keep the clock grinding. Keep it going. But you got to figure now, they're going to see more people stacked up at the line of scrimmage as they try and bleed it out.
Time for a break. We're back to see what happens after this. So the Titans in possession of the football here as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Out of the gun now on third down. They've got his man complete. 20, 10, 5, touchdown Titans. A big play there, 81 yards. And the Titans find a way to stretch their lead.
Well, it'd be real easy to say that they are firmly in control right now, but I'm looking at your face and I'm thinking I've got to be careful with that.
Well, it's a two-score game. You're inside of 2 minutes. I think you can breathe relatively easily now.
Yeah, you can, but still, you got to stay vigilant. Can't give up anything cheap and easy. That could put you in some jeopardy.
Scoring summary, three-play drive, and it ends with a Tennessee score. After the touchdown, Barth now to kick it away. And the Titans defense, they get ready. They take the field again. And last time, no points surrendered, almost. I mean, the ball was in the red zone. Bottom line, though, they got the stop. They'll be looking to do that once more.
And you know they trotted back out there with energy, because after you get a fourth down stop and give up no points in a situation where you expect to give up something, you feel so good about yourself and the guy playing next to you as well. That leads you to playing pretty well the rest of the game.
And we'll see if they can play well again here and get another stop. And he'll toss this one incomplete. Seeing no options, he throws it away.
Hope I don't sound too rah-rah on that one, but that's the exact right throw. Either your receiver gets it or no one gets it. Give him a lot of credit for being really precise with it.
Got rid of it. No one got it.
All right, here we go. Green.
Here's Barkley. Left side here. Caught by Clay. So he got three of one tackle, but couldn't do a whole lot else. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. Surveying the field. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And that one incomplete. Had some position, but couldn't hold on, and it brings up fourth down.
And when all else fails as a defender, when you're not there in the coverage, your best friend is exactly what we saw there. A big play shot taken by the offense. Unfortunately, it ended in a big drop.
They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. He's going to let it fly. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And the Titans, they've got the football back, and they've got it in great field position. A look at the running back, the man out of the backfield, as he gears up to go again. And as we peer at the numbers, he got off to a struggling start, but since then really found his rhythm.
And I think that comes together with not just the halftime adjustments, but just that quiet confidence.
And the Falcons going to use another timeout. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. So we've got a second and five. Another pistol look here. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he is going to lose yardage here. They got to get to the 20 to keep the drive alive on third down. They come out here in the eye. Now a carry here for their fullback. And he'll go down here right around the 23-yard line. It's a gain of 5, but it'll lead to a fourth down. So now the Titans are going to call upon their field goal unit here. This to make it a 3-score game late.
And that's why the fullback position was created. You just want a big, strong, powerful guy you can hand the ball to and pick up good yardage.
And you figure with that, this game's pretty well out of reach.
It would take a heck of a comeback at this point. Being 3 scores down, I think that's too much to ask with time winding down here in the fourth.
Here comes the Falcon offense now as they get set to take over here. They've lost this one. Their offense has struggled. Do they try to put together something here at the end just to take into next week?
Yeah, sometimes teams want to do that and coaches want to. I remember one time I was on a team and we were losing late in the game like this and you knew it was lost. It was over, right? And the coach called a running play and pretty much said to everyone, I want to see something executed well before we get out of here. And that was the message to the team.
Just something to build on.
Just something to build on. Get it done. And maybe we can look at that and say, we'll get better as we go forward.
Offense just a yard away from the line they need to gain. Third down. The play action fake. They'll look to throw. Catch here, left side, Thomas. And he will have the first down as he gets this to the 47. And now it looks like they're going to be in the hurry up. So second and 10 here. The play fake. He'll look to throw. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. So the long attempt falls innocently to the ground and it brings up third.
One of the toughest things about playing defensive back is pattern reading, trying to figure out what they're doing. And on that one, they had to fly, just sending a guy downfield with the in route accompanying it, what people call a dagger route, trying to hit the guy underneath after the clear out. In this case, though, they're not able to.
And now look at this. Big gain, but a fumble. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
And with that kind of a deficit, you can't afford to make any kind of mistakes. But it's been pretty symptomatic of what we've seen all game with them, isn't it? Down this big in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, you'd say an afternoon to forget, absolutely. The Titans offense now, they work their way back onto the field. They have the dream scenario you hope for coming into the game. Just one kneel here, and this game should be over.
And it's always the final play of preparation each week. The practicing of the kneel down formation, the victory formation. We've got a game in hand, and that's all they're going to want to do now. They'll put someone back deep just in case something goes haywire. But all in all, take the snap, kneel down, and shake hands. Yes, get out of there.
And Charles, I think when it's...